I'm really excited with new toys today, Joggles Creative Art Textures in a larger 6x6 size. Perfect for use with gel press plates and monoprinting, they're also suitable to add texture and pattern to many other surfaces. Use them as a stamp, add texture to clay, pattern a journal page background. You can do all that and more with these deeply etched texture plates. At their most basics, Creative Art Textures really are just unmounted stamps. In the past, we had textures that were long and skinny, and while I liked them, I always wanted something a little bit more. With these new 6¼ by 6¼ ones, we have the ability to apply texture to a larger area, and in general, I think that they're a little bit more useful. So this release includes 4 designs. This is named Boho Flowers, and you can see the print that it produces. This is Curvy, again, really interesting design, and you'll notice that some of these are detailed, like if you look at Boho Flowers, you can see that the details are pretty fine on it. Curvy is just the opposite. It's nice, chunky designs. This is Doodled Circles, and you can see, again, we're back to a more fine design, although this one has a definite more hand-drawn look to it. And then finally, we have Wildflowers. Again, we're back to more chunky designs. So with this release of 4, you have lots of different options to work with. Let me slide all of this stuff out of the way and bring back Boho Flowers and a plate. This is what I'm going to do first. I mean, let's just start with the absolute basics. I'm going to put some color on the plate. I'm going to use Boho Flowers to imprint it with a design, and then we'll pull a print and see what it looks like. So for this, I'm using Dina Wakley's paint. This is olive, and then the other color that I have is peacock. And as I like to say often, but don't always remember to do, too much paint with a gel press plate is not necessarily a good thing. It can really get in the way of you getting nice results. So I'm gonna do a little bit of a gradated color, but I'm not gonna spend a ton of time messing with it. I'm just not gonna mix them entirely. I do want there to be kind of a flow from the turquoise to the green. So we're gonna call that good enough. I'm gonna bring in, now I've gotta grab a couple of pieces of scratch paper off to the side here because I'm going to stamp the color off. I don't want the paint to accumulate on, this is a rubber stamp. I don't want the paint to accumulate on there. So I'm just gonna put this on and go ahead and press it with the flat of my hand so that I can imprint the design in the paint. And there you can see the design. Now I'm gonna put this to one side for a second. Let me grab, so I've cut some paper down to 6½, I think, by 6½. It just makes it a little bit neater when you do this. And how awesome is that? It's a really pretty design. I love the gradation from the olive to the turquoise. And now let's bring in another piece, and I'm gonna go ahead and do a ghost print. I don't know how much we'll see, but it's always worth giving it a whirl. Oh, see, that's pretty cool. I mean, we didn't get much here, but there's ways to use just this section here. Now, bringing in that piece of scratch paper, let me slide the plate out of the way for a second and bring this in. So remember I said that these are really nothing more than an unmounted rubber stamp. I can put this down. Now obviously I'm doing this on a piece of paper, but think about the possibilities. You can do this on a journal page. You could make a card background. There's lots of ways that you can use this. And is it a perfect stamp? No, it's not, but that's really not what I intended. If I wanted to ink this and stamp it as a stamp, I could get results that are a lot crisper than this, and you know, I wouldn't have this area that was missing, but that really wasn't my intent here, as I said. So you can also work with deli paper, which I always find to be fun. So let's bring the plate back in. This is some of our deli paper. I spent a long time researching this. I wanted something that was very translucent, so that it almost disappears. By the time you tear this and use some gel medium to apply it to a surface, whatever's not colored is going to be almost invisible. I'm gonna come back with the same colors again just because they're handy and they're easy. And I've still got color on my brayer so I don't even have to clean it. All right, go ahead and start moving this color around again. And this time I'm gonna grab Curvy and let's use it because it's right here. You know what, let's actually do Doodled Circles because this is gonna be a nice fine design too. And I think it'll show really well on the deli paper. All right, so I've got my design on there. Grab a piece of deli paper. Now with the fold, I never worry too much about it. It kind of is what it is. You just put it down and go ahead and pull the print. I'm never going to use this as a whole piece, so I'm not worried about that. Could I have done a better job? Absolutely. But you get the gist of what's going on here. You get that beautiful detail, and it's easy to do. So let's come back. I want to avoid the fold. This time I'll go ahead and stretch this when I come in for my ghost print. And now you can see that the fold is much less obvious. So all of this is fodder for journal pages, any kind of collage that you want to work on. Let me grab another piece of deli paper, since we're playing with it, and go ahead and stamp what's left on the doodled circles creative art texture and see what we get. Now some of this has had a chance to dry because obviously it's a very thin layer of paint and I've been messing around doing other things in the interim. But it's here, and there's a piece of this that you can use, very little design on here, but there's enough here that you could use as a little layer someplace where you needed it. So what gets interesting is when you build layers. I mean, this is very straightforward. This is very simple. All of these designs look great, and of course they get more interesting when you use multiple colors. But when you take the time, see if I can put my hand on something. When you take the time to build layers, I'll bring it in a minute when I get set up. When you take the time to build layers is when things can become very, very interesting. One of the simplest ways to create layers with a creative art texture is to take a more or less solid background like what you see here, apply paint that contrasts fairly strongly onto your surface, pattern it with the creative art texture, and then pull the print over the top. So I'm going to show you that right now. I've got two colors of Dina Wakley paint. I've got night, and I want to say that this is eggplant. I already have these colors kind of on my brayer, though they've mixed a little bit, but I didn't even bother to clean it. I'm just going to use it the way it is. The other thing that's important is that you use a paint that is at least somewhat opaque, because if you use something super translucent, you may not get the exact results you were looking for. So I'm going to go ahead and apply the creative art texture and press it well so I lift the color in the pattern, and you can already see what's going on here. Now if I can kind of grab this so that it more or less lines up. And it's going to be less lined up than more. I can kind of tell by the way that that went down. But you see how effective this is. You get the green that comes through in spots along the edges, sometimes more than others. And if I had done a better job lining it up, this green border wouldn't be distracting. But you get the essence of where I'm going with this. Now the other thing that you can do, for example, if I take, let's clean the plate for 1 second, just so that I have a clean plate to work with when I go to pull the next print. And if I'd been thinking, I actually could have just pulled that ghost print, but of course, I wasn't thinking, so there you go. All right, if I bring the texture back in, and I grab something else, and let's grab one of these index cards, or you know what, let's grab this page. This is one of our 3x4 disc-bound watercolor journal pages. I'm just gonna go ahead and print this on here, because again, why would I waste that if I don't have to? Grab some paper. And yes, I could have printed in other areas on this, but for now I'm just trying to do the one so that you can see. Again, it's not a huge layer, but when you build layers, when you build interesting backgrounds, when you build interesting journal pages or mixed media projects, it oftentimes is a result of multiple layers, some peeping through the background, some very indistinct. So this is fine. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. I'm going to move that out of the way for 1 second and bring the plate in. Now the other option when you do this is you don't have to completely cover your background. So I'm going to bring in, this is a 5x5 disc-bound watercolor page. This is oxides that are on here. And for this, I'm actually going to brayer the color off of my brayer. And I'm going to more or less just go with night because it's dark and it's going to give me really good contrast. But this time what I'm going to do is, rather than print the entire design, I'm only going to print part of it so that you can see that you don't have to have perfect layers. And in fact, I think perfect layers have a tendency to be boring. So let's go ahead and, this is curvy, so I'm going to go ahead and use this. This is another of the bold designs. All right, let's pick that up. And then rather than print the whole thing, I'm just going to sort of flex this page so that I can, it's not curled the other way, and I'm just going to go ahead and print a little bit. And again, now I've got pattern and texture, but it's very indistinct, And I've got the other layers that are in the background peeping through. And as I said, this is kind of the way to build really successful and interesting things. So I've got some deli paper here. This deli paper has a tear in it, but again, I don't really care. I'm just going to go ahead and print the ghost of what's on here so I don't waste it this time. There's probably going to be more than one ghost print that I can get out of this. So again, a layer for whatever, for something when I'm ready for it. Let's just grab one of these and go ahead and print what remains. So now the other thing that you can do, and it's going to take me a second, I'll see, that's cool. Another beginning of something fun. What I'm going to do is clean this off. I'm not worried about the plate, but at this point I do want to clean the bulk of the paint off of this curvy creative art texture. So actually I take that back. I am going to clean the plate because it's going to affect what I do. A little bit of water. Someplace here there are actually baby wipes, but of course I can't even find them. Alright, we are mostly clean enough here. Let's get some of this mess out of the way. So here's my plate. This time what I'm going to do is I'm only going to roll color on about two-thirds of the plate, and then I'm going to wipe the paint off my hands. Then I'm going to pick up color with the Creative Art texture, and I'm going to transfer it to this side where there isn't any. So you can, not only can you utilize what's on here by stamping it, you can actually print it on here and create a positive and negative look. So for this, I think, since I've got night on my brayer, I think I'm going to do a little bit of an ombre. That's probably enough because I do want to leave part of this open. All right. So I've got a nice thin layer of paint going here. I'm going to pick up my Creative Art texture and I'm going to apply it to the paint just like I did with everything else. Only this time I'm going to turn it around and I'm going to print it here. So now I've got that positive and negative thing going. See? And you get that really cool result. You get that transition, and now your pattern actually shifts because now I've taken what I've lifted and printed it here. So layers are interesting. There's ways that you can utilize them as you start to build backgrounds or whatever it is that you're working on. Up next, I'm going to bring in black, both as a surface and as a layer color. Black is one way to create intense contrast. I have some background that I've printed already, and I'm going to add a patterned black layer on top. I'm going to use Prima's redesigned chalk paste for a couple of reasons. First of all, because it's really opaque, but also because the finish is very, very matte, and I have some backgrounds that I printed with Finnabair's Art Alchemy Paint, so they're going to be shiny and kind of metallic, and that matte finish is going to provide a really good contrast. So I'm going to take that seal off. This is one of our, this is a 5x5 disc-bound watercolor journal. This is boho feathers. I'm going to grab a palette knife. Now, you have to be careful that you don't overdo it with the black, especially if I'm going to use a really fine design like this. So I want to get a nice thin layer brayered out on this plate, which is not exactly clean, so hopefully we will not see any debris that alters what I want to do here. All right, so here come boho feathers. Let's just go ahead and put that on here. All right, we will see what this looks like. Actually, I'm going to use something else that I've already got done here. So this is a background that I printed. Oh wow, how cool is that? Now it didn't line up really well, but that's a background that I printed with the Art Alchemy paint. I don't even remember what colors they are. I just picked a bunch and started to throw them around. So you've got strong contrast because you've got dark against light. You can see the colors through the background, and you've got the difference between... Actually, you know what? I take that back. That's not Art Alchemy. I have Art Alchemy paint on index cards here, which is going to provide us with an entirely different look. All right, so this is really cool. Now what happens, and it could be that this paint is just dried enough to the point where we can't use it, so I'm going to add a little bit more. We'll see what if there was enough left on the brayer to actually do anything. And let's just go ahead move that out of the way. Let's just place this face down and see if we get any joy here. I'm going to guess not. I think I waited a little bit too long, but we'll give it a whirl and see what happens. Nah, see, we didn't get anything from that. So that's fine. We'll put that to one side. But this, that's just bloody awesome. All right, so let me... I'm not even going to clean the plate all that much. I'm just going to quickly wipe it down with a baby wipe to remove most of the black. And then I am going to pick up one of those index cards that I had used the Art Alchemy on so that I can show you the contrast between the shine and that super matte finish that we're going to get with the redesigned chalk paste. All right, so this is close enough. Let's go ahead and get some on here. Again, I don't want to have too thick a layer because it will just obliterate everything. That looks pretty good. This time I'm going to grab Curvy. Oops, knocked some things over in the process. Go ahead and put this on here. You can already see the pattern on there, so it looks really cool. Let's grab this. So you can see the glimmer. This is the Art Alchemy paint that's on there. I'm just going to go ahead and kind of set this in the middle. It is what it is. And we will grab something else that I was playing with just to go ahead and press that on there. And then let's see what we have. Yeah, see, now you've got the glimmer, the paint, the Art Alchemy paint through the background. You didn't get a super opaque layer because I did put the black on the chalk paste on pretty thin, but it's all about layers. It's all about contrast, and you have both between the matte and the shiny and then the colors. All right, so let me bring in some of our black index cards. Let me put my hands on some of our black index cards. Let me remember what I did with the black index cards I had ready to show you. All right, so we will temporarily just hold off here for a second while I locate what I thought I knew where it was, and then I'll come back and I'll show you how you can work with black on black, which is going to create kind of a fun and nebulous effect. Okay, I found the two samples I was looking for. These are our 4x6 black index cards. Both of them had light backgrounds already printed over the black. Not super opaque, but they were there. This one, you can see that I used the wildflower design with black paint, and this one I actually used the curvy design with something reddish-orange. I don't remember what it was, but it works. I mean, both of these work, but as I said, you get this very subtle effect. Now, a moment ago, I showed you that you can use something, you can use black against white or something that's been printed on white, and even with the really detailed stamps, you're still going to get lots of good contrast. When you work black on black like this, I find that I get better results when I use the two bolder styles. All right, so with that said, what I'm going to do is work with these three samples. So again, I'm working with our 4x6 black index cards. This is all done with Finnabair's Metalik paints. I don't honestly remember which colors they were, but you can see that it's kind of green and blue, and I've got one here that's purple with a little bit of deeper purple on it. So I'm going to use Wildflowers for this one, and I'm going to use that, again, coming back to the Prima Redesign chalk paste, because I'm going to get a really flat black finish against that shiny metallic. Go ahead and get some paint out there. Now for this, I don't actually even have to put paint over the entire plate because my index cards are only 4 inches wide, so that's pretty much what I'm going to do. Go ahead and press this on here. All right, and lift it up, and let's see what we've got here. Let's just go ahead and put this down. I'm hoping that I didn't put too thick a layer on there. Let's grab a piece of scratch paper and go ahead and give this a good press. So you can see, here's where the paint is a little bit thicker. It comes down and it gets thinner, and so you can see the advantage to using a thin layer. But I've got that shine coming through, which you can see the light reflecting off of, and then I've got that really deep matte black finish. So let's clean this up for 1 second. Let me just go ahead. Actually, you know what? Let's just see if we can print most of this off. Let's do this one more time, and then I want to show you something completely different that you can do that works especially well with the really finely textured stamps. I'm going to actually bring in an ink pad rather than use paint. So this time, let's go ahead and grab Curvy. Now what I'm going to do, before I print what's on the plate, I'm going to come in and I'm going to take the black that's on here and I'm just going to press it on this background that I did. Let's see if we get any kind of transfer here, because this is always fun. This is how you learn. You do, nope, didn't get anything. You do all that fun experimenting and you see what works the best. So let's go ahead and do this. Come back with this so I can get some pressure on there. And then let's see what we got. So there's a little bit on here. This layer was so thin that I didn't get a lot of transfer. But what I want to show you now, so let's just get this plate out of the way, because the next one I bring in is for something else. So this is what happened when I took Curvy and I inked it and I printed it on another background. So I'm going to do that right now with the black, since the black is what I have handy. And I'm just going to kind of do this here so I can go ahead and ink the brayer, which will allow me to ink the stamp. That might not be enough paint. All right, so let's... hope there's enough paint on here. You know what I might do? Just give it the tiniest little mist of water and then go ahead and blend that in. Let's see what happens. Go ahead and put this down. Now the background is really light, so it's not going to take a ton of black to get some contrast, but I do want to show you this because I think it's a really fun technique. Okay, that's a little bit more like it, so we got it this time. But you can see how effective this can be when you take and you use these creative art textures like a stamp. All right, so I'm going to grab doodle circles because it's clean. At least I think it's clean. I'm hoping it's clean. It'll take me just 1 second to clear this up, and then I'm going to bring in another plate and show you how I use Tim's oxide ink pads to print something that's fairly fine like this. All right, paper towel. Oh, good grief. Take one mess and just make it a little bit bigger. All right, so here is our creative art texture. That one is doodled circles. Here is a nice clean plate. Always helps to have more than one plate when you want to swap techniques like that. And I have some distress oxide. This is peacock feathers in the ink pad. Now, the one thing that I can tell you about this is that too much ink, as always, is not a good thing. But I find that it's important to really brayer this out. Otherwise, the surface has a tendency to look a little bit pebbled. So again, I have a clean brayer. And I'm going to take a minute and I'm going to really smooth this out. And if I think I've got too much ink there, which I might, it's hard to believe, but I think I might, I'm going to brayer some of it off and then I'm going to come back and I want to really smooth this out. It's important when you do this that you have a nice smooth layer. All right, so let's make sure we have something to print on. Come in and grab the creative art texture. Now the nice thing about working with oxides is that they have a fairly long open time. So that means that what's on here will stay wet for a while, and what's on here will also stay wet for a while. So let's go ahead and print this. Ah, see, how cool is that? You get that really interesting patterning, super simple. Now, in and of itself, is this revolutionary? Nope, but when you combine it with other things is when it gets really interesting. All right, so let's slide all of this out of the way. And then the last thing, and I'm hoping that there's enough contrast here, let's try this. I'm gonna go ahead and print what remains on there. Actually, you know what, let's do this. Make sure we really have some color on there, because it's gonna be disappointing if we don't. As I said, this is really nothing more than a stamp pad, or excuse me, than a stamp, so let's treat it like one. Go ahead and brayer that color to smooth it out. I'm all for being able to use your tools, and I think of the creative art textures as just another kind of tool. I'm all for being able to use my tools in a variety of ways. And when you work with the creative art textures, you have plenty of, oh, how cool is that? You have plenty of options to do that. So these are our four new Creative Art textures. They measure 6 1/4 by 6 1/4, which is great because they completely cover that 6 by 6 gel press plate. They work beautifully with the plate. They work beautifully as a stamp. The designs are interesting, and I think they're going to make a nice addition to your creative stash.